Thank you, brother, for the introduction. This is one of the best introductions I've gotten in a long time. Thank you. So over here, both my brothers have given a lot of their insights into approaching the education and skill upliftment. Brother Azhar talked about reskilling and continuous education, continuous learning. And over here I know there are a lot of my elders who have probably more years of professional experience than my age. So I'm going to just try to convey my experiences around some of the topics that have already been touched upon and bring it down to something actionable that I see that we as a professional group out here to uplift the Muslim Ummah of our time can do together. So with that, let me explain that I have been one of those subjects that Brother Azhar touched upon. I've never excelled and scored more than 90 in my education career. I was always the guy who my parents used to say, we are happy as long as you stay between 70 to 80%. And that's exactly what I did. Throughout my school and my college, I stayed between 70 to 80. I was talking to brother over there, professor. There's new number, 65 to 70. I think my parents probably knew they gave 65 and I would have 65, so they just kept it up to 70, I guess. So I should remember year 2002, I was at Crescent College out for seeking admission. And I was very clear that I wanted to do it in computer science. That was my passion. Even today it is. I wake up thinking what I can solve today. And I think I used to be the same back then. And I said I want a seat for computer science engineering. The elders over there, they look at my request and they said, I'm sorry, we cannot, seats are full, but we can offer you polymer technology. I had a tough choice to make, get into a reputed college who's offering me a seat. I knew I would get a job, no problem. The other side was going to another college which was unheard of, a smaller college, but still I would be able to chase my passion. Alhamdulillah, I took that decision to go chase my passion and I got into a computer science degree course, completed it. It gave me a lot of tools and confidence to do what I'm doing right now. So I always tell this to my team members across my corporate career and even now to my startup that most of us, but any professional that is out there, we say we are engineers, but in true sense, engineers are not made by degrees or by the marks. Engineers are made by their passion. If you look at any class engineer or an architect or a top-notch businessman, you will see that without passion, they cannot achieve it. So in my roles as any leadership role that I play, even if it be a small role as a technical lead for a 5-10 member team, I have ensured that I educate my team on passion and make every single work, every single project passionate. And I think that's one thing that today when I talk to a lot of the young brothers who are trying to figure out a career choice, or trying to basically get into work, get into business, they are, while they have the ideas, they have the energy to take actions, but what is missing is, in some of them at least, is passion. And that passion is what, through leadership skills, through soft skills, and through mentorship, these three aspects we actually have to bring up to them. With that, I just want to touch upon another thing, something that I learned very recently. I have a 6-year-old daughter who just moved back from the US, trying to put her into school here in Bangalore. And something led me to a curious thought of what the school which all of us have gone through. What is the school model? Where did it originate? I just wanted to go into that now. So basically, I found out that the schools of today started off in the late 17th century, and the purpose for the school was very different than what we know of it and the way we implement it today. The purpose of school system that was created back then and hasn't changed much in the last 200 years is to basically take the people, when the Industrial Revolution and the more people needed the factories, the big bosses, people at the top, thought that you cannot take the people who are roaming about, sleeping when they want, waking up when they want, doing the farming, and put them into a 7-8 hours job, expect them to actually work and take breaks on time. So they invented or introduced the school system where they actually got the people young, got the kids young, put them into a system for 12 to 13 years, and at the end of it, this is what we got. What we got is what we see, that most of the students who complete schooling are excellent professionals. They work well, they have no problems in working in an industrial setup, but the people who do not go to the school end up being businessmen. That's what happened. Because school puts it in the head that, okay, your work is almost like school. You will go to the same 8 to 5, 8 to 6, and then you just have a few more responsibilities, you have a family, but the timing is the same, the break is the same, lunchtime, you're 12:30, 1 o'clock, you get a break, and they are pretty well immersed to it, and that's your life. People who jump out of it, they become businessmen, they become entrepreneurs. So coming back to the incubator concept that Brother Azhar said, I'm 100% for it. I have been both in an incubator as a startup founder. I've been working with incubators to guide people as consultant, as a startup consultant, and I think it's much needed. As a matter of fact, right from the Halal Expo that happened in Hyderabad a few weeks back, talking to a few brothers, I found out there are like 4 to 5 incubators already that at least are present in Halal Expo, and I have started to work with them. We have, as a professional group over here, we have to come up together and the like-minded individuals to set up more incubators, smaller incubators, not necessarily for startups, but also for traditional businesses. Startup is not, every business is not a startup. I just want to make this one piece very clear. The purpose of a startup is very different. The purpose of a startup is to get there, create a product, create a business, scale it 10x, 100x times, and then get going with it. If you are not, if you cannot do that, for example, if some brother comes up and wants to start delivering milk in their area, that would be, and if the area doesn't have enough milk supply, that probably is a great business idea, but it's not a startup, it's just a business. So I think our incubators should not specifically be for startups, it should just be for anybody who's out there to get a halal living, and we should actually support that and train them, because even in today's world, even for those kind of businesses, you need a lot of these skills. If you only startup, except other than startup, any business in today's world needs skill and needs one more very important thing, which Alhamdulillah, by the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we are working on in part of Collabu Technologies. So we have built a global SaaS, which is software as a service platform, and mobile apps, both Android and iOS, called, the brand name is Collabu, Collab and Collaboration, and the Collabu. The apps are available on Dean.app. So if you go onto your browser and just put in Dean.app, not .com, .app, you will be able to install the apps and get going on that. The idea, well, you will not see a lot of what I'm talking about right now. There are basic things out there about community, getting in there, events and other stuff that we pretty much talk about. But what's the vision is to basically start building technology that will support almost all actions of our ummah to basically where the technology is a barrier right now. Good example, coming back to the other Azhar's auto example that he was talking about. Today, there's a barrier of entry into getting easy rides, because you start up the Ola, start up the Uber, and they have different cost rates and stuff. They give you cars, they don't give you phones. Right, so if you're ready to get a car, they'll give it to you, but they'll not give you a phone. That's a basic necessity. We have brothers, we have members of our community who don't have a basic phone. My point is, what we are doing here is building the technology platform which will basically get them both the customers and the business and the technology. Well, no matter whether you're an educated person, whether you're a skilled person, as long as you have the desire to work, the technologies out there support you. I've worked in a lot of corporates, I've been in boardroom meetings, and I know the direction in which the bigger companies head out. There are a few good companies like Tata Group and other groups like that, but then most of the companies out there in the US as well as the world, they are out there to just make money from the technology that they have developed. Our vision is not just to get the profits for the investors, but also basically to turn around and provide those benefits back to the community, whereas the platform itself has enough funds to sustain. So that's the idea, and inshallah, the hope is that these platforms, we want to encourage more brothers and more individuals from across the globe to build platforms like these, because today is the world of technology, and without technology, even as a community, we just cannot proceed. So that's all I had. If you have any questions, you can always connect with me later. Thanks a lot. Goodbye.